That was fantastic.
That was so much fun. So who's going to do Ignite Karaoke tomorrow? Yeah? We'll only need five of you. You don't have to volunteer today. We'll ask you again tomorrow. But wow, that was super fun.
So great.
Wow. All right. So this is the moment that we've all been waiting for. It's time for open spaces.
It is indeed. My favorite part of the day.
Yeah, it's your favorite part of the day. It's my favorite part of the day. But before I tell you about my favorite part of the day, I want to tell you about the first time that I experienced open spaces. So I'm about to describe to you how open spaces work. And I was at a conference one time, and it was described to me. This was the first time I had participated in open spaces. And while the facilitator was describing what was about to happen, I knew exactly what I wanted to do to that day. And the thing that I wanted to do was not that. Not that thing that that person was describing, because it sounded ridiculous. It sounded like it could never possibly work. So I ask you, as I describe the process, to just remember me from then. And I want you to just lean into this, sort of be ready for something completely different. So the way that Open Spaces works, we as a conference organizers and we as attendees of this conference have enjoyed a really great program, both from our keynote presenters, our Ignite Karaoke presenters. It's been amazing. But frankly, most of you have been sitting in your seats as consumers for the entire morning. This is the time where we turn the conference over to you and you become true participants in the conference. And so the idea here is that we want to make sure that the rest of the afternoon, we are discussing the topics that are most important and most top of mind for you. And in fact, we are giving you permission to determine how the rest of the day goes. And it's actually more than just permission. It's responsibility. You are responsible for how the rest of the afternoon goes. You are in charge of how it's going to work. Well, let's be clear. I'm in charge of how it's going to work, but you're in charge of the topics that will be discussed. So let's talk about how it works.
Well, first of all, we have to decide what we're going to talk about.
We have to decide what we're going to talk about. So here's what I would like to do. I would like to invite each and every one of you in this room to propose a topic. Now, what does it mean to propose a topic? First, it means you have to be passionate enough about this topic to start a conversation. You don't need to be an expert in this topic. Your topic might be a question. It doesn't matter. All you have to do is kick off the conversation. And how are they going to tell us about their topics? What will they do?
Well, so if everybody in the room proposed a topic, some of them might be the same.
Yeah.
But a lot of them are going to be different.
True.
So we have to, as a community, we should choose.
We should. But before we get there, like, are they just going to shout them out to us? How are they going to tell us what they want?
That might be a little chaotic. I feel like we might be prepared to have them write it down for us.
Excellent. So we have some volunteers who are going to come through the auditorium distributing Post-it notes and smelly markers. They smell delicious, and we will all know which color you had by the dot on your nose, because we'll know what your favorite smell was. So here's the thing. You get a Post-it note, and we're going to just distribute them throughout the audience. Think of a topic that you would like to discuss this afternoon. Write that topic down on the Post-it note. Once you've written your topic down, we're then going to start a line over here along the wall. You will come up with your Post-it note. You will tell the audience, hey, I'd like to talk about whatever it is that you'd like to talk about. Pitch your topic or share your idea in like 30 seconds or less. And then you go over here and you stick it on the board, on the wall over here. And we'll have everyone propose some topics. And by everyone, I mean everyone that has a topic that they'd like to propose will propose a topic. And then, as you said, there might be some duplicates. There will certainly be some unique topics. And what we will do then is what a little piece of Open Spaces magic that I like to call chaos at the board. So we have time and space for about 24 different discussions this afternoon. But we're going to get more than 24 topics that are proposed. So how do we whittle it down to those 24? That's where the chaos at the board comes in. You're going to walk over to the board, and you will have a chance to vote three times.
Bless you.
How do you vote?
Put a dot.
You put a dot.
A dot next to the ones you want to hear.
So you have three votes. Topics are on the board. You put a dot on the ones that you want to hear. How many dots do you get?
Three dots.
How do I distribute those three dots? Does it have to be three different things?
No. You have three dots to do with what you please.
Ooh. If
you were really interested in one topic, you could put all three there.
Yeah, so I really want to talk about this thing. I'm going to vote for it three times.
Go ahead.
That's not how voting works.
Why not?
I don't know, but it's how it works today. So that's cool. All right, so three dots.
Three dots.
We'll determine what's what. And then we will ask everyone who's interested to help us move the voted on topics off of sort of the wall of ideas and into our schedule grid so that we know when and where those conversations are going to happen. We have eight different locations designated. So if you were to walk out this door up here, you would come to open space. If you were to walk out that door over there and go all the way to the end, you would find open space number one, and then number two, and number three, four, five, six, and then seven, and then eight. Seven and eight are here in this auditorium. Now, the idea here is that you go to these discussions and you have a conversation. And there's a couple of important things about a conversation. When I say the word conversation, what does it mean to you, Holly?
What? I wasn't listening.
Oh, yeah. Conversation. Yeah.
I think I'm supposed to listen.
Yeah, you should totally listen.
Yeah.
What else? Does it mean I get to talk the whole time?
No.
Damn it.
That's no fun.
No, it's super fun when I get to talk the whole time.
For the rest of us. I don't know what to tell you.
All right, right. So it is truly a conversation. The idea here is that we can learn from and share with one another. And we have a very hard and fast rule. In fact, it's so strict of a rule that it is called a law. And that is a law of mobility. So if you find yourself in a conversation and you're neither giving into that conversation, like giving something into it, nor taking away, what should you do?
I use the law of 2 feet.
The law of mobility?
Yes, the law of mobility.
And you leave that conversation. You just walk away.
Peace.
That's right. And the reason that this law is so important is because it's really twofold. We make it explicit because one, you are responsible for how your afternoon goes. I know that there are going to be great topics that you want to be a participant of. Go to those topics. If you show up and it turns out that the topic wasn't exactly what you expected, don't come to the organizers later and say, man, that was a shitty topic. That wasn't what I expected at all. It's your job to use your mobility and walk away. And at the same time, if you're talking and someone gets up and walks away, it's just because they're not getting something or giving something into that conversation. You shouldn't feel bad. Don't take personal offense to someone walking away from you.
No.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This is all about how do we get the most out of this afternoon. Now, how many of you, just a quick show of hands, are technologists? Like you write or run applications? Yeah, it's most of the room. And when you write and run your applications, how many of you use Post-it notes to do that? Right. Do you think we could design an application that would allow us to do this voting and like topic proposal that wasn't on Post-its?
If only somebody could do that.
Yeah, it would be terrible if we could get, it would be terrible. Because here's the thing about a conversation is it happens between humans.
It's true.
And so we want to start that process, get to know your fellow attendees right now as we are proposing topics and as we're selecting topics. When it comes time to vote, it will get chaotic at the board. That's okay, it's okay. We embrace that chaos, and it's going to turn into the best topic proposals ever. So the things that I want you to remember most, write down the topic, come pitch it, put it on the wall. After all of the topics have been proposed, we'll have a round of voting. How many votes do you get?
Three.
Three votes.
Three votes.
Can I do half votes?
No.
Oh, I was just going to draw half a dot.
No, how am I going to know if it's half a dot?
I don't know. All right, so three whole increments only.
Whole increments.
Okay. All right, we vote. Then whomever wants helps move them to the board, and then we start the conversations. Now, what's the criteria if I want to propose a topic?
that I have to be willing to start a conversation about it.
I have to be passionate enough to start the conversation. Now, here's the other thing. It is truly a conversation. That means there should be multiple voices. Most of us in this room have one mouth. Most of us in this room have two ears. So when you're in that conversation, listen twice as much as you speak. And if you notice that someone is talking way too much, what should you do, Holly? Yeah.
Everybody who's worked with me right now is going, we know what she does.
Yeah.
I would politely say, excuse me.
Yeah.
Let's hear from some other folks in the room.
Absolutely. Let's hear from other voices in the room. Make sure that everyone's voice has an opportunity to be heard. And this is not something like the organizers may be popping in and out. We're not going to police this. We're asking everyone to police this. So if you find that you're the one that's always talking, yeah, just stop. Just stop. Yeah.
I did.
Yeah, I know. You stopped also. All right. So what questions can I answer for you? Who thinks this is a ridiculous idea that's never going to work? Yeah. All right. It's cool. Thank you for lying to me. Be prepared to be surprised. Who would like to propose the first topic? All right. Would you come over to this side? And everyone who has a topic, as you're listening to topics get proposed, maybe you'll think of, it will inspire you to propose a topic. Just come start a line right along here. You get to come up on the stage. We'll give you a mic, announce your topic, and then post it on the wall.
Thank
and you.
You
can do multiple topics if you so choose. Thank
yes,
you for
can do multiple
demonstrating that.
Okay, I'm very troubled. The guy who kicked off the DevOps movement